Alright, Belle, how's it going today?
In 1996, we established the Turtle Rescue Team, and we set it up based on a template that I had experienced when I was in veterinary school at a different college. Four teams divided with a number of students per team and with one team on call each week. And in that first year, we saw about 50 cases. So this year, we're in our 17th year, I think, and we're expecting to break 300 cases for the first time. And our average load has been about 200 cases a year. About two-thirds of the cases we see are what we term vehicular trauma or hit by car. The rest of the cases are made up of a variety of causes. Chewed by dog is actually number two. Dogs chewing on turtles. Another common cause of turtles being injured are entanglements with fishing gear, whether it's the monofilament fishing line or fish hooks, maybe even nets. All of those traumatic lesions usually require some type of surgical care. They're very tough creatures, and the fact that the turtle team exists is because turtles are able to withstand being hit by a car if it's not a direct hit to be treated by our students. But sometimes the turtles can't be saved, and the most humane thing is to euthanize them. Still, if it's a female turtle, and they frequently are because turtles on the move to find a place to lay their eggs can end up on a road, which is why they're hit. The students will open up the turtle after it's dead, remove the eggs, and then carefully incubate them with the idea of hatching them and releasing the young back to where the mother came from.